patients, when they first come to see us, they concerned, am I really pregnant? And then, of course, once they know they're pregnant, how the baby is the baby healthy? Is the baby in the right position? Is the baby have any problems? And then the standard advice is treat yourself well, eat well, eat healthily, don't drink alcohol necessarily, don't smoke, don't anyhow take drugs. And if you take a very good care of yourself, much of the time pregnancy will take good care of itself. If you're talking about high blood pressure in pregnancy, particularly related to pregnancy, this is a condition that can occur in pregnancy. It can lead to severe complications. The baby, you could lose the baby, the mother could throw a fit, the mother could get very, very ill. And we think that this condition, high blood pressure in pregnancy, is probably related to some form of issue where the mother and the baby don't seem to correlate well. And the baby becomes something that creates a problem in the mother, whereby the blood vessels get blocked up. Because it's blocked up, and because of that, if the vessels are blocked up, the mother will get high blood pressure. The vessels in the placenta get blocked up, and so the baby will not do very well. And all this is somehow related to the fact that the mother and the baby are not behaving optimally with one another. Nowadays, there are some tests that suggest that we can pick up preeclampsia or pick up hypertension in the early phase. We think this is a process that begins maybe around 12 to 14 weeks of pregnancy and maybe presents itself later on, maybe 28 to 30 weeks. And you can also give them medications to try and prevent the blockage of the blood vessels so that eventually they will be able to hopefully reduce this risk for the mother. This test is now generally available in many hospitals that provide obstetric care. Patients often ask about, should I get a flu vaccine in pregnancy? Most studies seem to show that it's safer to have a vaccine and not get complications than to be fear the vaccine. So flu vaccines are considered safe in pregnancy. If there's any infection that we should be vaccinating mothers against, it's whooping cough. It's been shown now that whooping cough in infants have come up maybe 5 times over the past 5 years. So because of the increased risk to babies, we now suggest that mothers do get vaccinated in the third trimester, so to prevent infection in the baby. Ultrasound, perhaps the last 50 years we've used it in pregnancy, I think it's probably the best tool that has ever come about, God's gift to pregnant women and to the gynecologists. I think the key periods would be probably the first trimester. You need to know where the baby is, whether the baby is alive, how it's growing. At 12 weeks to 14 weeks, where you can do a lot of fetal diagnosis, definitely at 5 months or 20 weeks where you can do a full structural scan, and on and off in the pregnancy where you can check for the growth of the baby. Ultrasound also enables you, even in the last stages, to make sure the baby's head is down, to make sure the placenta is not blocking. So all these are quite useful. I think the first thing I'd say about pregnancy is on the labour process, it is painful. Anyone who tells you that it's not true is not telling you the truth. Every mother will go through labour pain. The intensity of pain, how much pain you go through, it's different for different people. Can the pain in labour be relieved by natural methods? Some people do try some of these things, tense machines, walking a lot, sitting in a bathtub. I think these things are not well proven to really relieve pain. There are also some medical methods. People do injections of morphine, people do give some laughing gas. But these methods, I think, are limited in pain relief. I think the most proven and perhaps very safe method of pain relief and shown to be effective even in the, all to the way to the end of labour and pushing time is epidural anaesthesia. That's probably the most effective. Generally considered quite safe now because anaesthetists are very good at doing this. And of course, they explain to you all the pros and cons before they do it. But I'd say by and large, the mothers will relieve it. Most of them, they'll say they'll always have it again, maybe have it earlier the next time around.